Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. And joining me today is Freeholder Deputy Director Gary Rich, who serves as the liaison to the Monmouth County Department of Finance. Freeholder, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Cynthia. Great to be here.
Great to have you. We are talking about a very important topic today. Let's talk about the budget. Tough time of year always when it comes to working on the budget. And let's talk about what's going on there.
Right. You're right. This is probably the toughest time of the year because when we introduce our budget, we operate the county on a temporary budget for the first 3 months or so. We typically have an introduction of our budget. This year it'll be around March 13th. We'll also go out to the county libraries where we'll be open to the public for them to make comments about the budget. And we expect to pass the budget in April. This year is exciting because since I've been on the board, this is my third year being in charge of finance. We're looking at, again, bringing our budget in with a 0% tax increase. So it's a wonderful thing.
A 0% tax increase. That must be challenging to do. You said for 3 years now?
Yes, absolutely. You know, I'm very fortunate that working with our county administrator and the other freeholders on the board, we've looked to how to become more efficient. We've looked at how we can shrink county government. And we've also gone out and asked our department heads to take a look at your business. Tell us where you think you can help us to reduce costs. They've been very, very, they've worked very closely with us, and the department heads have come back, and we're very, very close to getting to that 0%.
Absolutely. You know, and in this tough economy, you have to do more with less, you know, not just a county agency, but a lot of agencies, including the private sector. That's the challenge here. So let's cite some specific examples. What types of long-term initiatives you have with the county?
Right. Well, one of the things is that we do try to run the county as a business. So we really look at every aspect across the board. That's important to us. But one of the things that we were able to do this past year was we've implemented some new IT systems around payroll, human resources, and finance. So what does that do for us? If you notice what's going on in the business world today, it's about collection of data. When we have data, we can make better decisions. For the longest time, if we were buying too many pencils or we were buying too many trucks, depending upon what the products were, we didn't have a way to kind of look at them and say, we've purchased too much of this or too much of that. Because the way that the budgets are, there's so much money. The budget is $481 million last year, so it's very large. So now with that data, we're able to really figure out where our costs are and how we can better spend our money. So that's been a huge help. And we've had the internal people have developed these systems for us, so I thank them for all of their hard work.
There's also a new payroll system that...
Yes, there is a new payroll system, which is great because now we can go to direct deposit. For the longest time, people would get their checks. We'd have to print them. That was relatively costly. Now with direct deposit, we can put the money directly into their checking accounts. So that's going to help save us over time. We don't need to buy the paper. We don't need to buy the ink. It's not huge dollars, but over time, it's like anything. That just adds to where we're able to reduce our costs.
Absolutely. So they won't be handed the paper, the paycheck, anymore.
Correct.
Because it will be mandatory eventually that everybody has to have direct deposit, correct?
Well, we think that's the best way to go, and it seems to be the wave of the future. And everyone has been very, they've been very good as far as going to that. Once it's like anything. Change is difficult. Once you make that change, I think people find it to be very, very, very easy to work with.
Right. Absolutely. You know, cutting costs in this day and age is so essential. You know, I mean, everybody's complaining about government waste, correct?
Correct.
You know, you hear a lot of those complaints. So doing something like that, like you said, it may not save you a ton of money, but if you're going to save a little bit of money here and then a little bit of money there. Every little bit helps, correct?
Right. The other thing that we're looking to do is, you know, we have shared services. So we're looking to save not only the municipality's money, but we're looking at the county on how we can take advantage of the revenue that we collect. So we really have, I think overall, I have to congratulate everyone at the county. Everyone has stepped up to try to make this a budget. To bring it in at 0%, because that's important. I want the taxpayers to know that we are working for them, and that's important. This is a bottoms-up type of a situation, and we have a lot of everybody is working as a team, and that's really a great thing as a freeholder. So I'm blessed to have the team working with us.
And like you said, freeholder, you know, you have the public input there, mm-hmm. right? You're holding these meetings
correct
before you pass the budget.
Correct. We've been out talking to a lot of the municipalities, and some of my background from being a councilman allows me to try to understand what goes on in the municipalities, and based on that, we were able to kind of measure where we need to maybe put some more money, and then where we're able to reduce the cost on how we provide those mm-hmm. services. So having a background and getting out and speaking with the mayors and some of the council people also gives us some direction on where we need to be.
Sure, gains you a much better understanding.
No, we can't.
And Freeholder, you know, your background, with your business background, and like you said, being a former councilman, has that helped you deal with the budget process, which can be
yes.
quite overwhelming at times?
Yeah, I think, you know, working every day, driving to work like everyone else does, gives me a different perspective on how we're spending money. And I find that from a business, we're trying to change the way that we do things. And once we change, people come along. They don't really fight it in the beginning. But once they understand that what we're really trying to do here is maintain the jobs that we currently have at the county, we want to make sure that everyone is gainfully employed and that we're providing services to the taxpayers, that is something that they really need. So I think my business background, along with the backgrounds of the other four freeholders, we blend nicely together because everybody comes with a different perspective.
Exactly.
So I try to bring that to the board.
All right. Deputy Director Gary Rich, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Cynthia.
And for more information about the Monmouth County 2014 budget, you can go to www.visitmonmouth.com. That's all the time we have for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. I'm Cynthia Scott. Have a great day, everyone.